as we know, that is postoperative CD is a frequent phenomenon, and hypotony plays the key role. And quadrantic, that is throughout the whole quadrant, that is 65%, one quadrant, two quadrant, or three quadrant, and if the four quadrant is have choroidal detachment, it is called annular, and it is 35%. And there is annular choroidal detachment is the there is worst-case situation associated with usually retinal detachment. And if the CD present with us with there is a retinal detachment, this main surgery is to do the drain of the CD. If there is no scope to do any medical treatment or to wait. Why? If the serous CD continue, that is, it causes severe PVR sense, and the eye in the course of time become thysical. And when, as you know, that if CD is static, it is better to drain, not to wait. But if the CD is not improving, then drainage is the mandatory. Methods is a one-center study prospective, and all cases present with us with there is annular choroidal detachment with retinal detachment plus PVR cells. And the visual acuity was perception of light and on the projection of rays, and intraocular pressure is markedly reduced. This more marked hypotony is there. That is, IOP was 2 to 4 millimeter of mercury. And this is the sparsparana vitrectomy is done maintaining the infusion pressure 40 to 50 millimeter of mercury, and then fluid access endo laser, finally silicon oil access was done, and it is done, all the case was done by single surgeon Dr. Mohammad Munawwaruzzaman. And it is difficult to introduce that this is trocar, as the choroidal detachment extent that is in the anteriorly. So after introducing the trocar and another trocar to see, that is with light pipe, that is whether it is going within the vitreous or not. If it is in the choroid, then it will be serious consequences may be happen. This is the procedure, that is after doing the parsiflana vitrectomy. And if the some PFCL was introduced in the mid of the parsiflana vitrectomy, that we have seen, that is the annular choroidal detachment along with the retinal detachment and CBR PBR cells. And the most largest, that is where the peak choroidal detachment, point of the peak choroidal detachment, then radial incision was done 8 millimeter A from the limbus. Then got a puncture to drain the serous fluid. You have seen that is the fluid is coming through the hole. This is the situation. Result, that is, all the patient has got, that is, after 7 days, that is, retina become flat. There is anatomical attachment is there, and IOP was found, that is 11.1 plus minus 1.92 millimeter. And silicon was not removed at that time. Discussion, small CD often heal, the serous CD from leaking measures to close the leak. In some choroidal detachment requires surgical depth. And early surgery is better. In our study, very low IOP, 2 to 4 millimeter of mercury. This marked hypotony plays a role in doing annular choroidal detachment with retinal detachment and severe PVR cells. All 5 eyes in our study had 100% anatomically success, but after 6 months, the functional assessment is not good. And because of long study, choroidal detachment with retinal detachment causes loss of functional photoreceptor as well as the neurological cells. Limitation of this study is sample size is very small and short period. If you want to achieve functional success, we have to do the early surgical intervention, not more than 7 to 10 days. Take home message, that is early surgery, not beyond, that is you have to never wait, not beyond 7 to 10 days. If the patient came with us with annular choroidal detachment along with retinal detachment. And every choroidal detachment patient should be followed up in every alternate day. Conclusion, pars plana vitrectomy and drainage of choroidal detachment followed by fluid air exchange, endolaser, and introduction of the silicone wire provides better anatomical result in CD with RD. Thank you for patience of hearing.